I'm Mort Cooper, your host on Change Your Voice, Change Your Life. I have in studio with me, if there's any concern, please advise your children not to watch this program. It's not off color, but we're talking with Count Dracula and his friends. It may be frightening for younger kids to watch the Count, and it's a very telling interview. I hope you join with me. I'm going to ask the Count, if he will, why he has gone public.
Well, I want to tell you why I have gone public.
Is this for anybody to know?
Oh, yes, yes. You know, I like to fly at night. And when I fly at night, I feel at one with myself. You know, we're always looking to be authentic to ourselves. We all try, but it's very difficult to be that way.
I understand that. But why do you want to be authentic to yourself now? You've been flying all by yourself at night for years and years, Count.
I know. But, you know, I must tell you why I have done the interview with you, Dr. Cooper.
I'm as fascinated as anybody else, if you would tell me.
It's the blood. The blood. Do you know the blood is tainted now? If I take a little bite, I can die.
If you take a little bite, you can die.
Yes, the blood. You never know what kind of blood you're taking. These people in Hollywood and all over this place, they have pills and all kinds of things. You never know if you have a problem with HIV. I didn't even know that existed years ago.
Well, it wasn't. It's only a modern, up-to-date condition, Count.
Yes, but I found out late. I didn't know. I was taking a little bite at the castle. And then my doctor told me, you know, I have a good doctor.
You have a doctor, Count Dracula? Oh, yes.
Yes. Oh, yes, I have a good doctor. I took a little bite from him, too. Ha, ha, ha!
Oh, Count, be serious. You didn't take a little bite from your doctor.
Oh, yes. He's like me. He likes to fly at night. He used to be on pills, you know, that made him high. And now I show him how to fly at night. He doesn't fly with me, you know.
Well, whom does he fly with?
Oh, he has his own set, you know, the upper class here. They fly by themselves.
Count, are you serious about what's going on?
Of course. Why I want to tell you this story is because I want to be a professor.
You want to be a professor?
Yes, I want to get into a hematology program.
You mean hematology?
Yes, whatever you call it. I want to be a professor who would take care of the blood.
Why do you want to do that?
Because then I know the blood is not tainted. It's good blood. People are not tainted. And it can save my life. I could die from bad blood.
Well, that's happening with a lot of people. They die from bad blood, bad pills, bad shots, all of these things.
I know. I can't trust the medical people anymore. I can't trust the drug companies. They're very, very iffy.
What do you mean they're iffy, Count?
Well, you know, I must tell you, they vet.
They what?
They vet.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear that.
They vet. You know, they tell you something, but it's not true. They tell you that the pills, the shots, and whatever you take is true. It's okay. But you never know. You never know. They keep out what they don't want you to know.
Oh, Count, you must, you can't be serious about that. We have a very, very decent drug organization, you know. If I want to take it, do you take the pills?
No, I don't need the pills. Well, if you took the pills, you might die. You know, there are 200,000 people dying every year from legal drugs.
Oh, Count, where did you get that?
I read the newspapers.
You read the newspapers?
Yes, at night, very late at night. You know, the light, The light scares me. I can't face the light.
So how are you going to work in a department of hematology if you can't face the light, Count?
I'm going to work at night from 12 to 5 in the morning when nobody's around and I can get their blood.
Whose blood?
The normal people, you know, people like you. Ha, ha, ha.
Are you saying you're going to take a little bite of me, Count?
No. I want you to be my friend so you can tell the public why I don't have the cape anymore.
I noticed that. You are trying to dress like the rest of us.
Oh, yes. I want to be normal. I want to be authentic to myself.
Count, do you have any trouble with your voice?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I do. I have trouble in the lower throat. It hurts for me to talk.
Well, you know I'm a voice doctor, Count.
Yes, I know. That's why I want to do the program with you. I want to be authentic to myself.
Count, where's the problem?
It's down here. When I talk the way I talk.
You talk deep throat, Count.
Yes, I do. Ha, ha, ha.
Count, are you working with anybody to bring you to the public's attention?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I have a firm. I hired them. They're the top people in the country. I went to New York. I flew to New York all on my own. It was a wonderful experience. You know, sometimes people look out the window in their plane and they see me and they think they're dreaming and fantasizing. They take them, you know, that red light or whatever they do.
No, you mean the it's not the red light, Count.
Whatever that plane is, I don't know, but it's their eyes are bloody, you know, and they look out and they see me flying alongside them.
You actually fly alongside these planes, Count?
Oh, yes. Yes, I can fly faster than they do. Ha, ha, ha. I've been around for years.
Count, tell me more about your voice. You talk deep throat?
Yes. It hurts when I talk deep throat.
You know I'm a voice doctor. You're talking about my area.
Yes, I know. That's why I wanted to be interviewed by you. I want you to tell me how I should talk right.
Oh, Count, it's very easy to tell you how to talk right.
Well, I've been around for years and years and years. And you know, I've been everywhere. And nobody can help me. It troubles me when I talk and people say, "That's the Count." I don't want them to know it's the Count. I want them to know I am normal. I don't want to talk with an accent.
Accents are in, Count.
Yes, I know. But the little children, when they look at me and they hear me anywhere, they say, "Oh, Mommy, oh, that's Count Dracula." I don't want to be noticed.
So what you're asking me is to help you to be normal and not recognized. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yes, you can do that.
Do you anticipate taking a little bite of me?
Oh, no, not till you do what I need to be done.
And what is that?
I want to talk like you.
You want to talk like me?
Oh, yes. I want to talk so nobody says anything wrong with that person.
But Count, you've been around for hundreds and hundreds of years. You probably have dated back to prehistoric times.
Yes, I have been flying at night with the dinosaurs. Ha, ha, ha. I took a little bite one time, and they all disappeared. Ha, ha, ha.
Oh, Count, be serious.
Well, only one disappeared. The second one was a toughie, and I didn't want to fight with him.
What do you mean, him? How do you know it was a him?
Oh, I checked before I took a little bite.
Count, you're a very decent guy. You have a great sense of entertainment perspective. Is there something I can do for you other than your voice?
Yes, you can tell me why I come across as scary.
Well, Count, you have a funny way of talking. That style of yours is quite different than the normal people.
Well, how do you explain that?
Well, most people talk like this on the East Coast. You know, they talk right through their nose, and they have a strange sense of, you know, they talk like that. And it
I don't want to talk through my nose.
Well, what do you want to do?
I want to talk like you. I want to talk like 007. 007. Why can't I be like 007 and be loved?
You mean Roger Moore, 007.
Yes. The other one is too physical for me.
You're talking about Sean Connery.
Yes. Nice man. I took a little bite one time, and it was bad blood.
Bad blood?
Yes. I wasn't myself for almost a week.
Oh, are you down on Sean Connery, 007?
He's a very nice man, but the blood was bad. I like the other one, the one called...
Called?
You know, the one with Roger Moore. I like that one.
Have you taken a little bite from Roger Moore?
Not yet, but I hope to one day. One day.
Whom, if I may ask, have you taken a little bite in Hollywood? I don't want to know about the rest.
Oh, in Hollywood? Oh, there's one that I like very much.
Who's that?
You know, the one that talks with the deep throat.
The one that talks with the deep throat?
Oh, yes, you know, Henry the K.
Henry the K. Who is Henry the K?
You know, the one with the German accent. The one almost sounds like me, but doesn't have the flair.
And which one is that?
Henry Kissinger. Don't you know who that is? Irma Bombeck, I read her. She said if you miss the first few words of Henry the K, it's all over. Ha, ha, ha! She's right.
I didn't know you were reading the newspaper.
Oh, yes. Every morning I read the newspaper. But I do it in the dark because the light, it terrifies me. I can't take the light. And the course.
Oh, come on, Count. You know, that's a little exaggerated, the cross. The light, I understand. You know, when we wake up in the morning, Count, the light, it gets to all of us.
Yes, but when I wake up in the morning and I see the light, I go back to bed.
Back to bed?
Well, I mean back to the coffin. I like to be lying still because the light gets to me.
Count, what would you want to do if you were normal?
That's a good question. You know, those people that do interviews, they always say, that's a good question, and this is a bad question, and that is this, and this is that. That's a good question. What would I do if I were normal? Well, if I were normal, I would like to have good blood. Good blood. I have bad blood, and I need good blood. Therefore, I need to be myself, and not myself.
Count, I don't understand that.
Well, when I apply for a job, they always say, you're Count Dracula. And they call me Count Drac.
Count Drac?
Yes, you know, these people in New York, I try to get a job at the universities there, and they call me Drac.
Drac?
Yes, it's an ancient expression.
What does it mean?
Oh, you don't want to know.
Well, I do want to know. People would like to know why they call you Count Drac.
Drac means it doesn't mean a thing. It's all trash. It's bad, bad for you.
But I thought you don't react to people and what they say about you.
Oh, I do. I have a very, very soft heart, and it bothers me when people say to me, when you are the Count Drac.